I am the terror. I am the night. I am clearly made in China. And there you have. You have Bat Derp, folks. If you ever see some kind of crime going down in Gotham City, chances are this motherfucker right here is going to be too busy eating some Lunchables that Alfred made for him while he's wearing his fucking bat helmet, because you don't want poor little fucking Bat Derp here injuring himself. As a matter of fact, just so you know, he comes with movable legs and movable hands. That right there is pretty fucking impressive for a retard like this. And especially with his gray diaper that he has right there. So if he's going to drop any kind of bat guano bombs, then they're going to go right in there. And since he doesn't have a utility belt, all of his little fucking toys that he has, where does he get those wonderful toys? Well, he gets them right out of his bat diaper, which are now going to be soaked in piss and shit. So chances are, a lot of the thieves, a lot of the muggers, a lot of the serial killers out there and his rogues gallery are going to be scared shitless just because they don't want to get all that fucking doo-doo bat butter on them. But he's Bruce Wayne. What the fuck does he care? He's still a billionaire, even if he is completely and utterly retarded. Let's see. What else do we have? Ah, caution. Contains small parts. Not suitable for children under 3 years old. If you give this to a 3-year-old, chances are you hate them. That's all that there is to it, because they were worth absolutely nothing. And if this is the kind of Batman you want to present to them, they're going to have their mind blown whenever they see, you know, the actual Batman movies. Unless it's Batman and Robin. This right here would fit into the Batman and Robin world, because it's just as fucking stupid. Only unfortunate thing, though, is the back. There's nothing. We don't have no English here. We don't have a sad onion or anything. We don't get to see any kind of bastardized fucking story or backstory or anything like that, where it's just like, alright, Bat Derp went on an adventure in Gotham City, and he went to see Commissioner Gordon, and he fights a crime with Flobbin, and they go after the Jockster and Harley Quinn. And you don't get to see anything like that. It makes me really sad, because I love stuff like that. But naturally, the main thing that we want to do right now is crack this fucker open and throw all this shit to the side. There we go. It was already fucking coming open to begin with, so. Now, I want you to keep in mind that I've got a regular Batman figure, which I reviewed this one. This right here is Flashpoint Batman, which is absolutely fucking awesome and is badass looking. As a matter of fact, this is Thomas Wayne. This is Bruce Wayne's dad. This right here is not. This is like a love child with some kind of fucking foreigner who just so happened to be hopped up on PCP and a bunch of other fucking drugs, and this is what comes out is, Dad, I love you, get the fuck away from me. And then you have a Maury Povich episode, Gotham City style, and naturally, you know, you have some stuff like this, Dad, please love me. And then he's dead and he goes about his business. So you get to see quality and just leave his fucking cape right there, not like it matters. I use that to wipe my ass. So, and then you get to see dollar store Chinese quality. So, there you go. Awesome. Hogging up the camera. He's all like, "Mer, I'm badass. I will take down any of the hoodlums in Gotham City. They'll feel my wrath. I'll kill them, and I like chocolate milk. Yay!" So, there you go. Big difference in quality. So, let's set real Batman to the side and look at short bus mobile driving Bat Derp right here. Now, this thing makes me really, really fucking unhappy. You have to understand that right here, all he's going to do is sit down in his derp cave, and he's going to sit around and use his keen detective skills to find Waldo and, you know, basically look at the intricacies of pop-up books, and then off to training with the fat kid who does the lightsaber bullshit and stuff, and he's going to be like, judo chop, kick, yay! And what's even fucking, wow. Oh no! Bat Derp, your leg came right off. That's not good. All exposed ball joint. Let's get your leg back in there. Oh god, it won't go back on. Go back on, damn it! Alright, so we're gonna have him just stand like this. I wonder if I can get him to stand like that. This is like, there we go. He's basically like a paraplegic and a retard and a bunch of other shit rolled up into one. But you just do one of these and it's like, oh no, it's a penguin, it's Two-Face. Shit! No! So, as he carries his leg up to the camera, I want you to see something right now. Let me try one more time, get the leg back on. There we go, snap right into place. Look at the Batman symbol on his chest.
Look, it's got like two little feet. It's like Tweety Bird went and dressed up as Batman, and then they just stamped that right onto his chest, and he was just like, victory, yay! I like Tweety Bird, Looney Tunes, the best. We're animaniacs. We're standing to the max. But then you have his bat diaper right there, which I like to think that if this is where he's putting all of his wonderful bat toys, all of his gadgets and stuff, he more than likely is like Tommy Pickles, probably stuffs a fucking screwdriver inside there, and that's how he escapes from the bat cave, because Alfred obviously doesn't want him running amok throughout the city because he's just going to hurt himself, especially if he's not wearing his helmet. Now, this cowl is not going to do the trick, I assure you 100%. Even if it normally protects him from stuff, I mean, this dude could hurt himself from eating Lunchables and drinking a Capri Sun. So, naturally, going out into the rural city, yeah, he's gonna get fucked up pretty bad. So, and you know what, while we're at it, if he's gonna be like Tommy Pickles, we'll just say that Chucky is going to be Robin or Nightwing or some shit like that. So, on the back, we got some bat crack going on, some hardcore Batman butt crack. That's fucking amazing. I mean, we had bat nipples in a Batman movie already, and he has the bat nipples, I just fucking noticed that. Yeah, look at him. He's fucking high beaming. He's just like, oh, Commissioner Gordon needs me. I will signal back. Like, look at this shit right here. Oh, that is fucking awesome right there. And look, he got these extra bits of plastic up on his ear. Like, what happened there? Poor Batman just went headlong into a fucking tar pit and was just like, it's okay. I will save you from Poison Ivy's evil clutches. Wait. Nope. This is just JCPenney. Never mind. Sorry. Bye. And then he just leaves. And let's check out his cape here. His cape, which just snaps right on like that, as you see, and then just pops right off. It's just big stiff thing of bullshit right here. It honestly looks like as if somebody was jacking off into a sock for a couple months straight and then decided, hey, I'm just gonna go and put that on. Stiff as a board. And that's what it is. And it looks like it's like dripping and shit. This thing's ridiculous looking, just fucking ugly. So let's see about, you know, the movable legs and arms. So yeah, legs, they move. That's cool. And you know what? He actually will bend at the knees, so that's pretty cool. Will it matter much? Not really. So he can get down on one knee and he can propose to Catwoman, who will then be like, I'm sorry, but I would rather you just die in a short bus pileup. Also, they have good music, by the way. So there you go. Fuck you. That's what she would say, especially when your eyes are that close together and it's just like, what do you mean? I'm not a retarded. I'm handicapable of my arm. Shit. No. Help me. Alfred. Somebody, the Joker did that to me, I swear. It makes me so sad. Like, can you imagine him trying to enter into the Justice League? Like, something like this, they'd be like, no, you can't be part of the regular Justice League, but we do have something for you. You can be part of the Justice League Special Heroes Super Squad, and here's a gold star for effort. And he's just like, yay, gold star. Or just give him banana stickers. I mean, Deathclaw fucking loved him, so why not Batman? So, and I mean, he just looks so fucking retarded, from the really piss poor paint job on his face, to the fucking Tweety Bird Batman symbol, to his gray shorts. Like, what? Why does he have the gray diaper? I cannot fucking understand that for the life of me. So, there you have it. That right there is exactly what you get by going to a fucking dollar store. You get this. You get a retarded Batman. You get, if you pay a couple extra dollars more, you get a real Batman who just, pow, will fuck him up beyond understanding. So that's pretty cool. I love that. So there you have it. I hope that you enjoyed this review. I don't know what to call this. We'll just put that on him because this can be like a bat bib for him. Because I can definitely imagine him eating a bowl of cereal and you would need a fucking mop for that. A sponge and more than likely a bunch of prescribed medication and a brick to knock him the fuck out because he would just piss you off and annoy you to no end whatsoever. So, there you have it. Hope that you like this. Did you like this review, Bat Derp? Yes! Fuck you. Whoosh, and there you have it!
This comes flying in like a bad motherfucker, kind of like an Arkham City Center gliding around and everything. Though, if he tried gliding with this, his cape just pops right off. He's like, shit! So that'd be a good reason as to why he became all fucking retarded and just sitting in the back of the short bus with a bunch of other retarded superheroes. Even Batmite would look at him and just be like, no, you're pretty sad, dude. So, yep, that's Batman, Bat Derp, going to the Derp Cave, to the Special Justice League Olympics and stuff like that. Catwoman just would rather have her vagina flayed than to ever do something like this, and Alfred is most definitely his keeper, wipes his ass, gives him sponge baths and stuff, and just gives him a pop-up book and tells him to go about his day, being a keen detective. So, it's retarded Batman, Tweety Bird, fucking bat symbol and stuff, and his gray diaper, being Tom Pickles, escaped from the Batcave, being naughty. So, I hope you enjoyed this review. It makes me happy finding Chinese knockoffs like this. You have no idea. Like, you know, the fucking retarded Dragon Ball Z figure I did of Trunks, that made me really happy. Finding this, again, makes me happy. I just love generic stuff, knockoff stuff. It's funnier than hell. So, I hope you enjoyed it. So, from me, from Batman, wave goodbye, Batman.
Goodbye.
So, nerds, nerdettes, and gamers, and comic book fans, game the fuck on, and read comics, or die! And seriously, the Chinese make terrible fucking figures. It's so retarded, but good.